Eschan presents educational video lectures as per the AICTE curriculum. Difficult concepts made easy. Study anywhere, anytime.
In the first part of our session, we talked about, we discussed the subject-verb agreement, grammatical concord, notional concord, principle of proximity, and we discussed examples in details. In the second part, we are going to discuss more about the parts of speech, more examples on the prepositions, especially what are articles and how are they important for the accuracy of the language, why to use the articles correctly, why is it important to know what are modifiers, and all these details will be discussed in the next part of the video. Hello students, welcome to Eschand Academy. I'm Dr. Vidushi Bhardwaj. If you wish to learn more about vocabulary building, sentence construction, all the technicalities of grammar, reading comprehension, parts of speech, sentence construction, you may refer to English for Engineers, which is a wonderful book which will cover all the aspects we have already discussed. And of course, the book has a lot of examples where you can practice, and this will help you improve your vocabulary as well. The ebook link of this book has been given in the description box. You can refer to it. So we need to understand what is part of speech in order to understand the accuracy of language and how to use sentences correctly, because part of speech becomes a very important element of grammar. So what do we mean by part of speech? How many parts of speech do we have in English? That is what we should know. So we have 8 parts of speech: noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. Before we proceed, so technically speaking, when we write a sentence, each sentence is a combination of different words. When I say I play games, so I is a subject, okay? Play is a verb, and games again is a noun. So I becomes a pronoun. So all these, you know, words in a sentence are there with a purpose, and they perform certain function in a sentence. So keeping in mind the kind of function a word performs in a sentence, it is said to belong to a particular part of speech. So we need to understand what is the particular part of speech a word belongs to when we are reading and writing sentences. And that is how we divide these parts of speech into 8. The first is the noun. Now, noun is the name of a person, place, animal, or a thing. So, for example, if I say Ram is a good boy, Ram becomes a noun. So, it's something which denotes the name, which is Ram. And again, boy is a noun. So, nouns are important so that we can understand whom are we talking about. Now, pronoun is the word which is used in place of nouns. So if I replace Ram with he is a good boy, he becomes a pronoun. So why the knowledge of pronoun is important? Because that is how we replace nouns with pronouns, and the structure can change. We can also say she is a good girl instead of Geeta is a good girl. So, he, she, it, they, them, they are all pronouns. Adjective is a part of speech which is used to tell the quality of a noun or a pronoun. So, if I say Ram is a good boy, good becomes an adjective here. If I say she is a bad singer, bad becomes an adjective here. And that is how we use adjectives very carefully in sentences, because the change of adjective will automatically change the meaning in the sentence. Now, what is a verb? Anything which shows action in a sentence is a verb. So, for example, if I say he is running fast, he is running fast. Or if I say she is reading. So, running and reading becomes verb there. So, they both show action. While is a an auxiliary verb or the helping verb. So we have two kinds of verbs, main verb and helping verb. Main verb shows action while helping verb helps the main verb to complete the action. Okay, now what is an adverb? Adverb shows the quality of a verb. It enhances the quality of a verb. When I say he runs fast, she sings sweetly. So fast and sweetly, they are adverbs because they are improving. They are kind of enhancing the quality of a verb, which is runs and sings. So these adverbs again are very important part of speech which you need to understand. Then we have preposition. Now preposition, as the name suggests, means preposition. So preposition to a noun, usually it is before a noun and it is said to govern the noun that follows it. So we will tackle this topic in detail in our next video, where we will have plenty of examples on prepositions because they are very important part of speech to understand. So conjunction is something which is a connector or something which connects the two parts. So if I say Ram and Shyam are best friends, this and becomes a conjunction. And of course, they are used to connect two nouns or two pronouns. Interjection, as the name suggests, is to interject or to give a break in between. So it is used again in terms of showing sudden fear or sudden feelings or emotions. But we have to understand that interjection is not an exclamation. It is not grammatically connected to the rest of the sentence. So for example, if I say, alas, what will the poor man do now? This alas and an exclamatory mark is an interjection. While the exclamatory mark is always put at the end of the sentence, which makes it an exclamatory sentence. So interjections again show our sudden feeling. So these eight parts of speech, if we take care of these very well with good examples and the rules how to use them, of course, we'll be able to understand the correct usage of language also automatically. So let us see now what is a modifier. A modifier is a word, phrase or clause that modifies, that explains or provides description in a sentence. Now, why it is an important thing in grammar? Because it's known as a describer also. So it's a word or a phrase or a clause that describes another word or phrase or a clause. How? Now, what are the different kinds of modifiers? How are they important? Let us discuss that in detail. So we have different kinds of modifiers, mainly adjective modifier and adverb modifier. So an adjective modifier modifies nouns and pronouns. They modify in that they answer the following questions in relationship to the nouns they modify. So why are they important? If I say a cute baby, so what kind of baby? A cute baby. So cute baby here is important because it describes about the child. Similarly, if I say how many babies? Three babies. So three again is a modifier. So how much fruit? Enough fruit. With fruit we use enough. So it's a modifier again. Now, there is another category which is known as an adverb modifier, which modify verbs, adjectives and other adverbs. They modify in that they answer the following questions as to when, where, how often and how much. So, if I say, okay, so dance everywhere. So, everywhere becomes a modifier. Similarly, dance frequently. Frequently becomes a modifier. So, this important element in grammar, which is known as a modifier, is very important to understand so that we can use them correctly, because they would tell a lot about adjectives and adverbs. So that is how they will describe the adjectives and adverbs in the sentences if used correctly. Okay, then we can just take some examples here. So for example, if I say Look at these sentences and you'll find out what is the difference. Sue sat silently throughout the meal. The adverb silently modifies sat. Now look at this, sat and silently. Now silently is a modifier here because it is describing the verb sat. It's an adverb modifier. So we have certain examples where we would try to understand whether this is an adverb modifier or an adjective modifier so that we use them correctly in sentences. So let us see this sentence. We finally decided to stay where we were. So finally becomes a modifier because we are trying to explain we decided to stay where we were. So finally becomes the modifier of adverb. My father often reads the newspaper in bed. Often is an adverb and it modifies reads. So when we use these modifiers accurately with the verbs, so these adverb modifiers automatically grant a lot of meaning to the sentences and we understand how can we use it effectively. Now these ones are the ones which are the adjective modifiers. So for example, he tied red and orange ribbons round the present. Now what is a noun here? Ribbons. While red and orange, they add to the quality of ribbons because they are the colors. So these red and orange become the adjective modifiers. Similarly, dark clouds were gathering in the west. Clouds is a noun and dark is a color which tell about the quality as dark. So these are adjective modifiers. So why the knowledge of these adjective modifiers and adverb modifiers is important? So as to use these modifiers in the language accurately, so as to give meaning to the adjectives and adverbs. And if we try to understand the relevance of these modifiers, we are not going to commit errors. Let's move ahead with articles now. Now article, as we all know, they are very important elements in grammar. We have definite articles, we have indefinite articles, and it is a word used to modify a noun, which is again a person, place, animal or a thing. So technically an article is an adjective because with the number, for example, if I say we have two different kinds, definite and indefinite. So when I say definite article, the is the definite article, indefinite article, a, an. So when I use a book is on the table, a becomes an indefinite article. When I say an umbrella is lying on the floor, an becomes an indefinite article. But when I say the book which is black is on the table, the becomes a definite article. So the book which is particularly on the table is dark. Again, we are trying to give meaning to that particular book which is black in color. So the usage has to be done very carefully. So when we say definite article or indefinite article, we have discussed the examples. Let us proceed ahead with a few examples again. So definite article, we already discussed the word the. So it is used before singular and plural nouns when noun is specific or particular. So for example, the apple I ate was tasty. So we are specifying the apple which I ate. While if I say an apple a day keeps the doctor away. So that apple is any apple which we eat will be healthy and happy. So there is a difference between the usage in both the articles we have to understand. So these are the indefinite articles. We have already discussed about these. Still, we can have a few more examples. The choice between a and an is determined before, by sound before a word. So that means when do we use an and when do we use a? So an is used before the vowel sound words. For example, if I say an umbrella, an honest man, a university. So an honest man, the sound here is of o. So vowel sounds are a, e, I, o, u sounds. So when we have vowel sounds, we use an. While when we do not have the vowel sounds in the words, we use a. So a book, but an umbrella. Okay. Similarly, if I say a cushion cover, while I can say an honest man. So the sound has to be, seen and noticed very carefully. So this you know, initially may be a little difficult for us to understand, but with practice we can understand. So we have other examples: an egg, an hour, an honest man, an umbrella, we have already talked about, and so on. There, the list is endless. While, a book, a girl, and so on. So we have to understand what the sound is like in order to use the indefinite article am versus the indefinite article a. So these are some practice exercises we would like to just check as to what should we write here. I like to play the football or the basketball. My parents gave me a basketball for my birthday. She is the prettiest girl in the school. I have an idea. Let's go bowling. I have borrowed the money from her before. My first apartment was on the Orange Street, because we are specifying which Orange Street. The dress she is wearing is blue. He is a real gentleman. So this is the end of part 2 of the session. In the part 2, we discussed about the parts of speech, some examples. We discussed in detail about what do you mean by modifiers, how many kinds of modifiers do we have, what is the importance of understanding adjectives and adverb modifiers. And then we discussed about articles, definite articles, indefinite articles, how do we use them correctly, and so on. If you wish to learn more about vocabulary building, sentence construction, all the technicalities of grammar, reading comprehension, parts of speech, sentence construction, you may refer to English for Engineers, which is a wonderful book which will cover all the aspects we have already discussed. And of course, the book has a lot of examples where you can practice, and this will help you improve your vocabulary as well. The ebook link of this book has been given in the description box. You can refer to it. If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell to get updates about the future videos.
All rights reserved. This video has been prepared for educational purposes only. No part of it may be reproduced or copied without the permission of the copyright holder.